this is Fred, and welcome to The Shed. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Fred Mascherino. I play music as The Color Fred, and I used to be in the bands Breaking Pangea and Taking Back Sunday. Being in those bands put me in direct contact with a lot of the bands that were part of the emo boom of the 2000s. I toured with a lot of these guys, and it's been really fun to go back and revisit these times through these reaction videos. If you haven't seen the first one, I'm putting a link down in the description. Some friends of mine convinced me to do a reactions video last year. I had no idea how well it would go over, better than I had ever imagined. A lot of you left comments suggesting songs I missed or should have done, so I decided to do a part two. Please give the video a like and subscribe to my channel, where we're posting weekly content, including original songs, guest appearances, and more reaction videos. All right, the first song is AFI, Girls Not Grey. And I'm a big fan of these guys. Everything they do looks so damn cool. Oh! I'm not sure I remember the bunny rabbit. I haven't seen this in ages. Just cool as hell. Like, these guys had way more style than most other bands, I think. They were kind of around before my time, and then through that, they were kind of on a major when I crossed paths with them. Occasionally, I would be staying at the same hotel as them, but I didn't know them very well. I talked to the drummer a bunch. They were kind of more like mysterious. So this album was recorded by Butch Vig, who did like Nirvana, Smashing Pumpkins. But in the early days, they were on Nitro Records, which was founded by Dexter Holland of The Offspring. But I really like how these guys progressed into this era, and then they kept going beyond this. But I'm a big fan of this era of AFI. It's like so much imagery. Like, their guitarist Jade is so good. I never really talked to him, but his brother actually worked for Taking Back Sunday for a while, came on the road with us, and I freaking love that guy. Yeah, this just kills. I don't know how you wind up with these other elements in your video. Like, sometimes we would be making a video and they'd just be like, we got this crazy idea and we just went with it. I wonder if they wanted the bunny rabbit and the girl. They probably did. All right, awesome. Starting off strong with AFI, hell yeah. So this one is Thursday, Understanding in a Car Crash. So for my scene, as far as the emo explosion, this is the video that started it all. This is the first thing, it was on Victory. First thing on, we ever saw on TV of any emo bands. And it looks really fun. I wish I was there. Splintered piece of glass falls in the sea, gets caught. Broken windows, open locks, reminders of the youth we lost in trying so hard to live. There's Steve. Yeah, so I definitely hung out with these guys a lot. This was recorded at Big Blue Meanie, where Tell All Your Friends was recorded, Taking Back Sunday's record, before I was with them. But at that time, when those two bands were recording there, I was in Breaking Pangea, and we recorded at Big Blue Meanie. And Steve was hanging out there the whole time because I think his brother worked there. But this was a moment in time. Holy shit. And I see why this was the breakthrough video. It's like, this is post-hardcore at its best. So all those victory bands that came in those years, this was the very first one. This video started it all. They just did a live stream during quarantine. It was a huge hit, and I'm just so happy that these guys still play together. That means the world is in balance. I was in Australia once with Thursday. That's when I really got to know them the best. That was one of my best tours ever, I would say. So good. The guitars are surprisingly clean, though. You know, you don't hear something for 20 years and then you put it on. It doesn't sound how you remember. This doesn't look how I remember. But I love it. I love you, Jeff. Okay, the next song is Dashboard Confessional, Vindicated. And I see the Spider-Man comic book. And I see Tobey Maguire, and that means one thing. This is for the Spider-Man 2 soundtrack. I remember this because we were on this. Taking Back Sunday was also on the Spider-Man 2 soundtrack. And that was a huge deal, man. That was the biggest movie, and all these bands we knew were the bands on the soundtrack. Crazy. This was the single for it, though. I always play this at my emo nights when I go do emo night, and it's the biggest hit still. It's the sing-along. So I have a lot of history with Dashboard, actually. Breaking Pangea opened for Dashboard in the very early days, and I've maintained a pretty close friendship with Chris. So I gotta watch what I say on this one. Now, I've always been a big fan. He's the sweetest guy alive. Did you guys see that Emo's Not Dead video with Chris in it? So damn funny, Mr. Dashboard. That shit's so funny. So, another thing, and I sometimes mention this, but I was almost in this band two different times, and just didn't work out timing wise, but that's how Chris and I became friends. This is the part. Oh, I'm gonna cry. This is powerful shit, man.
tangles on a string, like slow string redemption.
Let's watch that one again. I could listen to that three more times.
Is it worth it? Can you even hear me?
Okay, the next one is The Taste of Ink by The Used. I really like this song. There's Quinn. I miss that dude. So, these guys are all good players. Jeff's an awesome bassist. Brandon went on to play in Rancid after this. And Quinn, the guitarist, he's one of the dudes in our scene that I really respected. Like, there aren't a lot of, like, we weren't known for guitar heroes in our scene, but I thought he was so cool. Just a great guitar player. And you can hear it. It sounds great. So, Take a Back Sunday toured with The Used before I was in it. So we would run into them and they were our boys. But I remember playing a show in California, like maybe the middle of the state. Some unusual place we played with them. Definitely played some festivals, but I didn't get a lot of time together with them. But they were on Warner Brothers at the same time as Take It Back Sunday. And I remember we went to this lunch at like the president's house, the president of the label. And Bert was freaking hilarious. He was, he kept saying shocking things to the president of Warner Brothers. And the guy didn't know he was kidding. He'd have to say, I'm just kidding. Like, I just thought it was the funniest thing ever. He has a lot of charisma. It's also crazy that he dated Kelly Osbourne around this time. And I used to see her around. She would come to the shows, and it's like freaking Ozzy's daughter. That was pretty wild. Those were the days, weren't they? Great song. Love this. I think this was John Feldman recording this one. He had a lot of hits at that time. Woo!
This is Quinn from The Used. Check out
theused801.com.
Download it, backfile it, type it up. Theused801.com it. Enter.
See, Bert's talking right now. He's hilarious. Come on, man. I don't think he's our... Yeah. I love it. Born entertainer. You guys know what this one is. Paramore, That's What You Get. So many people asked for this on the first reactions video. I know that dude in the bed. That's a friend of mine. Oh shit. I haven't seen him in a while. So I knew some people in their camp, but I didn't know them before this. I mean, that drummer was 17 years old when they recorded this. So I knew some people that worked on this record. David Bendith, who produced it, is a friend of mine, and I knew some of these other guys. And I got to hear this record like months before it came out. And this is such a strange rhythm. It's like 3/4 over 4/4. And when I heard it, I underestimated the public. I was like, this is gonna confuse people when they hear it. And boy, was I wrong. Everyone freaking loved it. But when no one's heard it, you just don't know if it's gonna be a hit or not. But now it's a no-brainer. It's like, I know all the words. So my daughter, she's in her first year of college, and she played music. But when she was young, when she was like 4, she met Haley. And I think that inspired her to play music. Now she plays music. It's pretty awesome. She's gonna kill me for saying that, but I don't think she cares. She loves Paramore still. Yeah, I can't say a bad thing about this. I don't know what else to say. It's just an instant hit. I can't wait to go out again. I can't wait till they let us out of the house and we have concerts again. I want to go dancing with you guys. This is the only band I did on my last reaction video that I'm repeating. And I think it's obvious why. It's freaking My Chemical Romance. Welcome to the Black Parade. When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band. Haven't seen this guy in a while. This is awesome. He said, son, when you grow up, would you be the and the doctor's mask there has a new meaning these days. Shit. Ugh. As if there was any question why I wanted to do these guys again. This is freaking perfect. I did Helena on my first reactions video and the album before this. This is like, to me, like the dream fully realized. Look at them, completely in control. Already amazing. Bob on the drums. So this was another time where I got to hear this album before it came out. Those guys came on our bus and played us this song, and we had just finished an album. I just finished our Louder Now video. Had just finished recording our Louder Now album. And it's just like, God damn, Yap did us again. It's just the vision behind it is so well thought out. It's just beautiful and gritty and perfect. Man. I have to bring up the fact that they reunited right before COVID, and we all missed getting to see it. I know it's still gonna happen again, right? It's got to, right? This is like the super Queen part. I like Queen a lot too. So, this had to have won like best video ever made, right? I mean, this is ridiculous. Look at this. They just don't make them like they used to. The Kings right there. I'm gonna cry. This is the most epic thing ever. I'm gonna go outside and run around. I gotta get this energy out of me. All right, next is Finch Letters to You. Can't you see that I wanna be there with open arms? It's empty. I gotta admit, I'm not that familiar with Finch. They look so young. Eddie from Taking Back Sunday used to be friends with these guys, so I probably met them, but this was one of the ones my friends put on the list that I figured I'd learn about a new band that a lot of you did request on the last one. All right. We got old dude creeping on the young guys. This is good though. I mean, it's very emo, but it's very good. Oh, old dude's scary as hell. I think I know where this is heading. This is kind of ahead of its time. Oh man. I need to know what happened to that guy. Did the old guy get that kid? Please tell us the end of the story. That's just radiators lined in that whole room. That's pretty creepy. Uh-oh. He's making soup, I bet. Oh, no. That poor kid. That dude is genuinely scary looking. But I would listen to that. That's cool. I back it. Hell yeah, I'm glad I learned about a new band today. That's killer. Okay, Angels and Airwaves, The Adventure. Now these are some old friends of mine. Taking Back Sunday initially toured with Blink-182 when I was first in the band. Then Tom started Angels and we brought them out. And then I started The Color Fred. And Angels and Airwaves brought The Color Fred out on the road. So I have a lot of hours in with these dudes on the road. So I'm glad we're doing this one. Mr. Tom DeLonge. Dave Kennedy on the guitar. Adam playing drums. Of course they got Elon now. And they got my boy Matt Rubano on bass. If, in case you don't know, Matt Rubano is the bass player from Taking Back Sunday that during the time I was in the band, and he's in Angels and Airwaves now. I love that they're playing in space, and you know why. This is like Tom's life now. It's law of attraction. He wound up doing space full time. The coolest thing is, about a year ago, I went to see Angels and Airwaves. I talked to Tom. We actually got to talk about, you know what? Aliens. He said, you know what he told me? He told me 100% that they're real. And I do believe him. I really enjoyed this drummer. And there's my man, Dave Kennedy. He's from Boxcar Racer. I did a couple Warped Tours with him. He was also in this band, Hazen Street. And he has a really good coffee place in San Diego that I've been to. And they're all decked out. I think Tom's got his Macbeth wear on. Hey, any of you guys wear Macbeth shoes back in the day? I certainly did. I was the Velcro guy. I still love this stuff. The coolest thing about touring with a band like this is you get to hear this song every night on stage, night after night. You're like, let's go out and watch their set. And that is the best part about being on tour, to me, is watching other bands that I really like night after night and knowing that I can watch them again the next night. And I'm lucky to have been able to do that. I love Tom DeLonge. I mean, who doesn't? You know what I'm saying? Oh, this sounds familiar. This is Taking Back Sunday. This photograph is proof. I know you know. I always like that drum beat. So this is my band, if you can't tell. There's me. So we just saw Angels and Airwaves. That guy, Matt Rubano, is in them now. And Tom DeLonge directed this video. And he had all these cool ideas. This was all planned out by Tom, with multiple cameras doing multiple things. Eddie wouldn't be reading. I kid you. I love you, Eddie. So this was one of the few songs that I sung some leads on. We always had the double vocal thing, but I sung the choruses of this song. These were my lyrics, and I really liked this song at the time. I'm glad it became a single. See, that was done with two cameras, one on each side. This was all from Tom DeLonge's brain. And we were standing there the whole time. That was a neat room where we shot it, though. I've always been an SG guy. That's all I play out usually. This title of this song came from a piece of art that I found. It was the most emo thing ever, if you can find it online. It's this dude, he has a picture of him and his girlfriend. It says, "This photograph is proof." And I really loved it because of how emo it was. So that's why we named it this. It's a little fancier guitar here at the end that I was always proud of, but I don't know if people notice. Eddie with the spin. Eddie has the moves. He was like a very good football player, so he's fast on his feet. Adam's wrecking shit. I love the nostalgia, but it hurts a little bit. You know it. You hate to see that the time went, but then you want to embrace it because it feels so good. And that's what happens to me during that song. And all these songs, honestly.
The nostalgia is real. Thank you so much for spending this time with me, guys. That was so much fun. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel. I will see you guys on the next one.